Another day, another dollar. About to head to this trip, going to Philly. Got a couple of folks I haven't seen in a while, about to meet up with, do some sit downs, do some podcasts, get down to business, meet some new folks in the middle of a pandemic. Life is great. Well, that's why I tell myself anyway. Oh yeah, for all those who are wondering, my name's Juice. Juice Jones. When everybody asks, is that really my name? I simply tell them the truth. That's exactly what my mom calls me. Well, let's see where today takes me. And just like that, we out here. DC. That's currently where I reside. About to head to Philly. I have no idea what the fuck I'm doing. It's a vlog. This is gonna be great. First time, first day. It's like being at school and shit. And we're back. I have no clue if you guys can hear me right now. Just went to a Union Station. It's really interesting traveling during COVID. Because, like, you know, you guys don't know me. I don't know you, of course. And it's kind of just like, how can you read someone's face expressions when everyone has a mask on and this is technically a vlog? This is going to be interesting. Really funny experience. Talking to yourself, cracking jokes, all this other shit. Let's see what's up. So, almost got stuck in a quiet car. That would have been really interesting. Speaking on a camera phone in the quiet car. Everyone wondering why is this guy not quiet in a quiet car. So, obviously I picked out the car that I'm on. Black. Sweatshirt, you know, 6 lakh. He gets paid for both, so it's kind of nice. I wish I got paid for both my names, that'd be fun. But, you know, let's see how this trip goes. Supposed to leave kind of soon. And there's a lot of mask on. It's kind of nice. Nobody tries to sit next to me with my mask on. That'd be awkward, you know, social distance and all that other stuff. I wonder what my audio sounds like on this. Am I sweating? I must be working hard. It's a good day.
Philadelphia's 33rd station in just a few moments. Philadelphia is your station stop. Please take this time to check around your seats and any overhead luggage rack for all your personal belongings. Please watch the step while the training. There will be a gap between the train and the platform. We thank you for traveling with Amtrak and we hope you enjoyed your trip.
So it's funny that I'm doing this now, because fun fact, I used to be in motherfucking Philly all the time, from like 2008 till about, 2012, I used to be back and forth between DC and Philly. Is that like 5 years or some shit like that? I wonder how much this all changed.
Here. If you don't get life, then you get murdered and die here. But somehow I survive here. 365 round hairs like a dog here.
Oh, you saw me floating outside of here. Oh, you got your girl there? I got the camera. You just got Sam. I did. Okay. Bad bitch vibes. Okay, yeah. This is your home, your new home. Are you going to let everybody know who you are? Or do you want the cameras upside down?
Okay, that's you. You're perfectly framed. Say hi. Introduce yourself. That's my life, so you don't got to worry about that.
My name's Eliza.
What are you into?
I'm really into... lactating milk porn.
What's in my hand? And you like what? What do you like?
I like sake.
Uh-huh. This? Okay. You know? Okay, hold this. No, hold
okay.
It. That's yours.
Okay.
All right, so you like sake.
I like recording our beautiful podcast.
You also like...
I like tequila.
Uh-huh.
I do like tequila. I do like tequila.
Oh, it's their new home.
This is the housewarming gift. Big vibes.
All right, what's good, everybody? Welcome back to the vlog that I've never shot before, because this is episode one and shit like that. It's your boy, Juice. We'll go with Juice. We going with Juice today? Juice, we fuck with Juice? All right, cool. Yeah, we going with Juice today. So, I obviously didn't record the rest of yesterday. It was a long day. Bumped into my friends, shot a podcast. I might even, throw in some clips and shit like that. Probably, right around here.
That you surround yourself with based on Juice and his experiences in D.C.
So we not going to introduce him?
Yo, yo.
He here now. This is your show. Fuck the question. Look at him. He beautiful.
Your hand is kind of nice.
Give me manicure.
Right. Yeah, shit was good. So let's talk about COVID and traveling during COVID. I feel like that's something that's, very interesting that a lot of people would be interested in. I took a train from DC to Philly because I was curious, outside of just seeing my folks, I wanted to see hey, what are the requirements going to be between DC going to Philly, COVID, the numbers just being a little bit under 200,000, and seeing hey, are they testing from station to station? Are people wearing masks? Are they kicking people off trains and shit like that? So no one gave a fuck. All right. That's just a great start. Just put it out there. Well, the mask, yes. It was, you had to wear the mask just to come into the building when it came to Union Station, going over to Philly. What was the name of the station that we went to?
30th Street Station.
Yeah, 30th Street Station. That's Elijah in the back, by the way. He's the one that's talking. If you hear a voice, it's Elijah. Plus the music. Yeah, hey, you heard that? Hey, one more time.
Coffee was hot.
So 30th Street Station. They weren't testing anyone. Everyone was wearing a mask, including the homeless people. So that was great to see that. I hope they're supplying people with masks out here in certain cases. All right, that's a no, definitely a no. No test. You came into the city when it came to getting off the train with no issues. I know for parts of New York and a couple of other states, it's very mandatory. It's mandatory for you to get tested. This isn't one of those places. But still be careful, of course. I get tested once a week in DC. Where I'm located in DC, we get tested for free. It usually takes 5 to 7 days. But for the most part, what I've noticed is usually get results back in 3 days. That's the only reason I decided to travel for the shows that we're working on between Mental Health Monday. My friend Elijah and his girlfriend Renee. Well, no, not Renee, Rayshawn. Please, I hope she doesn't ever hear that I got her name wrong. But yeah, the Entangled Podcast, that's the name of their show. You should know the show if you're coming over here to do show. I'm going to interview a young man named Marquise today. That's
so I did want to say a huge thank you. We also had two musicians mm-hmm. part of this, and then also another musician who mm-hmm. lent me his music.
Okay, Marquise.
Mm-hmm.
Tequila keys.
Mm-hmm. Definitely gonna be some dope shit. Activists within the community of Philly has had to sit down with the city council over in Philly. He's traveled the world, studied abroad. He just recently dropped a documentary, so this is definitely gonna be some dope shit. I just wanna hear about his life growing up in terms of BBW, which is Black Business Wednesday, a show that I'm gonna be creating and working on from September, which we're about to get to the end of, until the end of August. And, to add to the other projects that you guys see me put up. So when it comes to the color palette project stuff that I've dropped with the clothing and shit like that, I have no plans on ever being a voice of any kind on that side of things on those drops. But when it comes to the vlog, I'll be a voice, I'll be a face, because that's what the vlog is supposed to be and shit like that. When it comes to outside of the vlog, Mental Health Monday is a platform that I've been working on now for about a year and a half. So you guys are going to see a couple of clips from events that we've done, a couple. Thank you.
sit-downs that we've done with therapists within the Black community. We're going to have stories. I'm going to work on storytelling, going to work on building that platform correctly. And the vlog is probably what I'm going to use because I'd like to have a different outlet for like a lot of things that I work on, a lot of ideas. I have a lot of people that I think need to be explored correctly, and I'm just looking forward to us building it, you know, in its fullest. That sounds right. So for now, thanks for coming, all this other shit. I need to do something with this hair, but I hope everyone's day is going well. I think the next time you guys see me, working wise or on a phone wise or vlogging wise, because I am technically still traveling, and yes, I am in Philly, it's probably going to be with Marquise in the studio, the rec center over in Philly off Market Street that we're going to next. So I'm definitely looking forward to that. So see you guys soon. I wonder how many minutes is this vlog going to be for like the first one. How many times did I curse? I might want to change that. But yeah, you know, see you guys soon. These edits are going to be tight. Well, I'm looking forward to it. All right, so see you guys later. Did you want to do that? Did you want to do that thing with that song that you just did as you blend it?
What did I just say?
There's some soap in this house. There's some soap in this house.
I can hold different soaps. Mm-hmm.
I mean, if you want to. Nah, we on smoothies though. But like it was just a good I'm recording. I just got my hand over it because you're not blending, and I wanted to like present you well to like the folks that are watching.
I feel you.
You know, right, but you had like a dance. Wait, are you done?
Yeah, I like this sorbet like mix.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
So when you put it in the actual pop, you just push it up.
All right. Well, you know, that being said, hey guys, this is Rayshawn. She's out here, you know. Her and Elijah, they date and they own a house together, and like they successful together. And here's her smoothie. You want to tell us what's in this smoothie? I said you niggas date like you guys aren't in love and shit. That's crazy. Wow. So what's in this smoothie? What we got going on out here in Philly?
Frozen strawberries.
You said frozen strawberries.
Frozen bananas. We got a little bit of kale in here. Can't really see it, but that's a good thing. Let's see. Did I say frozen peaches, frozen bananas, frozen strawberries? A little bit of kale and orange juice and coconut water.
Okay. So where's your... words later, but that's her. She just be doing it. She be in the kitchen making motherfucking smoothies and shit. But this right here, this jewelry, that's Rayshawn's. Yeah.
Oh, hi.
She put orange juice in her smoothies too. I ain't never seen that. That's Popalicious.
Popalicious.
You got coconut water? You gonna put that in there too?
Oh, I do have coconut
water. Fuck it up. Hey. Fuck it up. Hey. Fuck it up. Hey. Hey. Break that. So where's your experience come from, you know, in terms of like these smoothies that you be making? You know, what inspired you to smoothie it up? Are you gonna have one? I would like to clink with you. For anybody that wants a close up, this is like one of her.
Okay, green, call it a masterpiece. Red or orange?
You know, I'll take a orange.
Okay.
Yeah, because my name is Juice, so that makes sense. Oh, it's a straw. Okay, that's nice. Sweet. All right, that's okay. On the gang. It's kind of smooth. All right. Okay. Okay. All right, that's you right here. About to see this clink, you know, what it's working on and stuff.
Absolutely.
All right, there we go.
This is my big old bag of frozen peach that I had back in June. And just, you know, let me know what you think.
Okay.
Hella citrus.
Hella citrus? Yeah. Okay. Schoolboy Q would be proud of this one. Yeah. Oh, we got some on the side. Be careful.
Oh, no.
Don't have that drop. Oh, no. Oh, someone catch it. There we go. The spoon. The spoon caught it.
Because the spoon is full of sugar. There's no fructose or sugar added whatsoever. Mm-hmm. It's all just fruits and
vegetables. Elijah, are you drinking one of these smoothies with us?
I'll sip some Rayshawn's.
Okay. Cheers. What color is yours? Red?
Red. Cheers.
Mm. Thank God I'm good at sucking. This thing is it's nice.
Like I said, no sugar.
Mm-hmm. Oh, this
nice and sweet one. From the peaches and the bananas. And gotta love that pink flavor, that pink color. Everybody love that pink.
It's almost like you can start a business from this, man. This is, I'd sell this, I'd buy it, I'd do both. You never know.
All right.
Well, we're about to go get some steak. So I'm gonna see you guys later. Oh yeah. Just like that, my folks have taken me to D'Alessandro.
Jack H and John E.
Oh, okay. Okay. So what kind of steaks you guys getting, guys?
Regular cheese steak.
Okay, okay. Okay.
Okay.
Uh-huh, uh-huh. Mass, you know, you got your little makeshift. I like that little arts and crafts. Let me help you out. There we go. That's you. That's you right there. You know, anytime.
And it's that good, because it's Tommy. It's Tommy.
Yeah, you know, Tommy got you. Tommy got you. Trying to get some steaks for the road before I head back to D.C., because, damn, they cash on me. Thank God I was paid in cash today. Thank you.
Yeah.
It's always love when I come around. Nothing left to see me coming since the ultrasound. A man in the cloth, cold criminal minded, carpet on the move.
Like a
look who cut force, fair, all of the rules. Paid all of the dues. I need the receipts. I need the
life. And just like that, I am back home. I got here, took off all my clothes, and totally forgot that I was working on a vlog. Was my first vlog, so Philly trip was definitely a success. Got my cheesesteaks.
11, 15, 17 yards, death by those kind of cuts. John Smith making Mitch presentable. Well, the Bears are 2-0, despite the fact they've been out.
Got the content, got the interviews. Shout out to Marquise, that was an amazing sit down.
I didn't know that there was so many different things going on. So, Dear Reading was created out of frustration that people left us behind and did not think of our city as any more than the violence that was perpetuated by the Reading Eagle, by the local newspaper and shit like that. So I think that was really just like, how do we take back this very specific narrative?
He curses, and like I curse
Negro,
the same
it's very intentional about its purpose. Like, which is not like rational on your podcast, but it's very much so like reading out so
like, and
the
like, Sean,
there's still a privilege
did you
of me
know?
Going to college and I acknowledge that because there's a level of information in a certain language that I'm not privy to that other people aren't. So how do I take this information and make it palatable?
One of the cameras that I was shooting B-roll on, I'm pretty sure it died, but that's cool. It's my first trip doing a whole production by myself. Shout out to The Rec Room, I think is what it's called, over in Philly. That was tight. They let us use their resources through Marquise's membership, which was dope because Elijah let me know about that resource, which was cool too. Yeah, and I'm home. I have no clue what to really end this on. Oh, shout out to everyone who basically sold me out of 2 to 3 colors that I've been selling for the Mo Love shirts over in DC. That's really nice. Appreciate you guys. In terms of the mental health brand, I do not have the link in the bio. Probably won't be putting the link in the bio until we re-up on stuff because we're selling out pretty quickly. But yeah, thanks for everyone who helped me out today. First vlog. I don't know what this edit's going to look like. That's going to be interesting too, doing a vlog. And, you know, after I do this first one, I guess I'll just figure out if I want to do more vlogs after this. But it was a great trip. I'm looking for more opportunities between, like, New York, New Jersey, Philly, Baltimore, D.C. Those are going to be my focuses. We're going to spread out. I'm going to look forward to working with more people outside of those areas and just telling these stories correctly. Vlog-wise, I guess you guys won't understand the interviews that we do between Marquise, myself, Elijah, and them in terms of the Entanglement podcast. I'll probably put their links down for anybody who's interested in it. I know the channel's like small right now because I just started it, and getting the YouTube dynamic, that's going to be an interesting thing. But thanks for coming. I appreciate whoever watches this within the few views that we have. I know a couple of people told me they were going to subscribe. It's funny. I have like Instagram and I have like good attention over there, but I want to see how long would it take me to just grow this channel within a year of like just natural relationships, people watching what we're doing, travels, how we get around, people we're working with, what we're looking to do. And if people are interested in, I'd appreciate anyone's feedback. If there is no feedback though, that's cool too. Hopefully I'll get it right, whatever right is, because I know that's relative to like who watches your channel or who tunes in. But this is exciting. I'm looking forward to failing, learning from my mistakes, and doing the best job that I can. So this is Juice Jones. What? Well, I didn't introduce myself as the White Juice Jones, but I'm just used to being Juice Jones because that's usually the general of what everyone calls me. So, but I hope everyone's night's going well. Hug your friends. Hug your friends. Remember self-love. Thanks for coming out. I appreciate the blessings that are in my life. And I hope everyone has a good night. And if it's daytime, wherever you are, have a good day. And just good luck in general. Yeah, there it is. And stay safe. Wear your mask. Wear your mask. Wash your hands. And be careful because it is dangerous outside. So tomorrow, actually, now I think about it, I got to go get tested. I get tested once a week in terms of the production company and the stuff that we work on and the content that we're building. I'm only allowed to do this because I have been getting tested once a week since June. That was when they started doing public testing to people within DC. And I do that once a week because the people around me, the people I work with, and it's just good to know. And a lot of people that I work with are doing the same. That's the only reason I'm outside doing what we got to do. So get home safe. So you'll see why that's ironic at some point in the future. But peace.
This shit.